Now we are deriving the displacement equation. Derive the displacement s in terms of initial velocity u and final velocity v. So that displacement we have to derive from the initial velocity u and then final velocity v. So in the first equations of motion, v is equal to u plus at. This is the first equation, isn't it? Next, the displacement equation equal to s equal to ut plus half at squared. This is an second equation. Now from that first equation we need a value, that is an acceleration. So the first equation v is equal to u plus at, from that we take a alone. So a is equal to v minus u divided by t. So that a value we are substituting the equation number 2. Equation 2 is an s is equal to ut plus half at squared. At squared. Now ut plus 1 by 2 a value v minus u divided by t into t squared. Now we are cancelling t and t. So the equation should change. Ut plus 1 by 2 v minus u into t. Now we are multiplied inside by t. Ut plus 1 by 2 vt minus ut. So the 1 by 2 is common for both u and v. So ut plus 1 by 2, sorry, vt minus ut divided by 2. Now we are seeing the terms ut plus vt by 2 minus ut by 2. Now the first term ut should be multiplied and divided by 2. Ut into 2 divided by 2. So this is into vt minus ut by 2 by 2. Now it becomes to 2 ut divided by 2 plus vt by 2 minus ut divided by 2. For our convenient, we are exchanging the terms. 2 u2 ut minus ut by 2 plus vt divided by 2. So here 2 ut minus 2 ut by 2 minus ut by 2 becomes to ut by 2 plus vt by 2. So it should be, we are taking the 1 by 2, here also 1 by 2 commonly out, and then here also t term is common, here also t is a common, so we are taking out. So that is a u plus v divided by 2 into t.